Module-based planning provides complete planning and budgeting solutions for financials, workforce, capital, projects, and strategic modeling with built-in, best practice, predefined content, including forms, calculations, dashboards, drivers, and key performance indicators. You create a project on the Project Summary tab by selecting Project Details. Let's enter project information for an internal IT project. You can set the project priority and rank. We'll make this a high priority project. Let's enter project assumptions. We'll enter standard rates by job code. We enter a standard hourly cost that will be used to calculate labor expenses. Let's take a look at our assumptions for working days and hours. These assumptions will be used in labor-related expense calculations. We plan to calculate labor expenses using driver-based expense planning. With the remaining driver information entered, we can calculate expenses. We have some expenses that we want to enter directly. Let's key expenses for specific expense accounts. Let's take a look at the overall project costs. Here we can see both the driver-based and directly entered project expenses. You can quantify project benefits to capture their measurable impact on internal projects. Benefits can be categorized as financial, non-financial, or qualitative. For example, you can plan for incremental revenue from digital leads for a new website project. Often, projects need non-financial benefits to justify your investing in them. You can measure those benefits by entering target values for them. This helps provide justification for the project. You can also capture qualitative benefits. If we take a look at this list, you can see examples of non-financial benefits that you can add. Let's review the overall project summary to see the overall net project benefits. Now let's take a look at contract projects. When you plan for contract projects, you can include details similar to those for internal projects. For example, you can include driver-based assumptions or directly enter values. With contract projects, you can also include revenue planning. The dashboard provides an overview of project expenses and shows the impact of your assumptions. You have a few more options to select when creating a contract project. After entering basic information, you can select the type of project, revenue recognition, and revenue cash flow. For contract projects, you model expenses similarly to how you model expenses for internal projects. Let's look at some of the differences for planning your contract projects. You can review the driver-based revenue, seeing both the assumptions and a graph. You can also include additional direct revenue, such as contract revenue, at a fixed price. An analysis provides a review of the total project revenue. Here we can also review the project's profitability and cash flow, which is built on our project analysis. The project summary shows data across both expenses and revenue to give you a snapshot of all the key performance indicators. This is a great page for obtaining the information you need to secure project approval. Now let's review capital projects. When you work with capital projects, you can review all the associated costs together on one page. You can allocate costs to specific assets. It is here that you plan for the assets that are part of your project. You can allocate project costs to one or more assets, and you can either fully or partially allocate costs for those assets by specifying a percentage. I'll make some changes. After you save your changes, asset information is displayed in the bottom form. Calculate to update project expenses and share the information with capital. Depending on the asset class, you can modify information, such as the depreciation method. Information is populated based on the asset class. After you complete your project's modeling and allocate costs to assets, you can review the project summary. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.